All right, so first clip of week 9, yeah. And I've been talking with some clan mates. I know the chat box is super small, but and I realized that next winter weekend, well, this one is higher. What is it? Increased node and reward, increased node spawns and reward points at RuneSpan. So I'll probably stay here for a little while. I wanted to grind out until I get double natures. Don't think I'll do that much, but I'll stay here for a bit. And next week is increased chance of rare drops and enhanced ring of wealth, as well as charm drops give one more charm than usual, or than normal. 50% increased base Slayer XP. All assigned Slayer tasks are treated using a Slayer VIP ticket. And cheaper instances, which I don't think will matter too much. So, I am going to go for Ascension crossbows. I'm not going to get them all at, by that point, but that means I'm going to try to get chaotic crossbows, which means 3 million Dungeoneering XP or 300k tokens, and then use what I have to grind out Slayer to 81, and then I will grind in the Monastery of Ascension, at least like prefer Ascension creature tasks, and just grind out like all weekend there. Because if I could get a few signets, because I need like two of each signet to get an Ascension set, and then I could preferably use those Ascensions to like go for racks and get T90 weapons. Like, none of this matters for comp cape. I wasn't planning on going for T90 weapons, but if I could get them, it would be awesome. I might decide to go for final boss or something like that later, and going for final boss or even just, I have to get a full set of Barrows gear right before I can do Mauritania Legs 4. Just killing Barrows brothers over and over with T90 versus T80, it'll make a difference, and then I can do it'll help me in my Slayer, it'll help me in summoning, grinding out charms, help me in prayer, herb lore. I can kill much better bosses with herb drops at that point. Seed drops from Ganodermics will be so much faster if I'm using a T90 versus a T80. It's got a ton of benefits. So if I could get these Ascension crossbows, I will. So yeah, that's a bit of a plan. If it means I can't get Prif this week, I'm not worried about it. I still do want Prif as soon as possible, but this winter weekend is a very good thing to prep for and to take advantage of. Yeah, so that's just a quick look at my plans for the upcoming week, and yeah, I really need to start writing this paper. So, spent a good portion of the evening out with the girlfriend. It's past reset time now. Oh, I should go. I think these are the last Sliskelion pieces I'll ever get, because I'm pretty sure they're going away as of like next week. Yeah, so last one to put on herb lore ever. But as per the poll, a lot of y'all thought that I should get auras, so I did. Out of my 55,000 points, I spent 40k, and I got Jack of Trades and Vampirism. Gonna go do Jack of Trades now. Vampirism, and I can get all three of the combat styles for 3% accuracy if I want to. Or I can wait and get like Master Jack of Trades or like Penance, something like that. I just chose Vampirism because it'll be a while till I get Soul Split, and it'll be really useful for Slayer and kind of necessary for a lot of bossing, at least to save supplies. So I'm gonna go take care of this real quick. It doesn't take that long. And yeah, gonna just put this on herb lore every single day. Hopefully I'll remember to do it every single day. And yeah, so I'm now using auras. Start of day 58 over here in Miscellanea. I just upped my coffers another 10 days worth. I didn't realize today it hit 675,000, so it was going to be inefficient if I waited any longer. I wasn't paying enough attention. So now I've got another 10 days worth here though. I have it mostly focused on herbs, which is great. I think that's the that's the last bird egg I need, I think, for the different god birds. So some Renars, some Irrits, and Aventos and Quarms. I should have nearly enough to get to. Alright, you see here, yeah, it's like 1.4 mil sitting here. I should have nearly enough to get to 69, and then at 69 I can blow through like 200 Lancidimes, going for anti-fires. Oh man. I'll just have to collect some blue dragon hide, blue dragon scales and grind those. It won't be too difficult. So don't know what I'm gonna work on for a little bit. Probably nothing while I finish this paper. It's about halfway done, but I kind of need to focus. It's difficult. So I'll go work on that, and then let's run through these bird nests to see what seeds they give. Hopefully, some good stuff. Those are kind of meh. Eh. A pineapple seed is alright. You can start buying those from Prif whenever I get there. Curry tree is similar to pineapple, I think. Similar amount of XP. Okay, I'll just grind the rest. Alright, on to the next clip. So, yet again, something else is coming up in my personal life that's going to bring me away from the game for a little bit, but re-rolled yesterday's daily. It was magic logs. Now it's a DG floor. Only reason I'm taking this DG right now, and I didn't take the one last week, is because I'm trying to get 90 so I can do ports like really soon. I didn't take it last week because I didn't really need the Dungeoneering XP. I'm going to get Dungeoneering to 99 eventually, probably during this grind for Chaotix, and then affording the repairs for them. But after that, I'm going to just disable DG dailies until I get everything else to 99, and then I can pump out those to 120. Oh, where is that ring? Oh, there it is. Okay, so going to go take care of this. Probably won't make too many clips. I probably will at 90, but I'm gonna be going for a while till I get chaotic crossbows. That's currently the goal. So, actually making another clip while dungeoneering. Only a few floors in, got an undead curse bearer to drop an empowered catalytic staff. So I'm gonna go over here to my bind setup and remove like this thing. Sure. Oh, and I think I have two shadow silk hoods. Don't need that. And I'll bind this. Awesome. Don't need those. Let's see if I can put a fourth item yet. No, I can't. I think I can at level 90. So then I can start wearing a shadow silk hood to go with this stuff. And at 90, mage, I can use the empowered catalytic staff. Awesome. And here, turning in the DG challenge after doing a few floors. It's like 84K, so I mean, it saved me from doing like three or four floors. Got a thing with the GF coming up. You can see I'm 200K away from 89, which means probably ports after just a little bit more grinding this afternoon. Also, I'm up to almost 20,000 tokens, which is a 15th of the way there for my Chaotix. That's pretty good. It means I've got like, I don't know, 15 hours left to go or something like that. So, starting off day 59, still doing Dungeoneering. I lost like all of last night. I didn't spend any time on RuneScape because there was this like Christmas party to go to. Starting back up with this. It seems like my plan for the week is kind of ruined. I mean, I can still go for the Ascension crossbow if I want to, but it appears that boss drops like Signets or, yeah, I don't know, like God Wars Dungeon, dropping armor, that kind of thing. That's not affected by the winter weekend, it's just going to be like rare drop table stuff. So it would still be a good idea to do Slayer over the weekend, but I don't know that I'll necessarily be grinding for Ascensions. I'm going to still do Dungeoneering like past this prestige, because this prestige is almost over. Yeah, the floor 45 because I just unlocked it. So about 500k XP left to go, but that's just to get 90, so I can start doing ports, and then yeah, I don't know. I think I might just go back to going for prif requirements because, you know, if there's no real incentive to push for ascensions right now, I don't think I'll ever really need ascensions before getting comp cape. So yeah. Yeah, I guess I'll just go back to doing the normal thing. Still got some quests to take care of, so I might do those. I've got my weekly tiers of Guthix. I can throw on summoning right now. Then, you know, take care of like while Guthix sleeps by boosting my farming level. The usual stuff. Oh, I can't forget to do Jack of Trades today either. And get some dailies built up. I might just take care of like these three right here. Alright. So this week's Tiers of Guthix was a lot better than last week's. 171 tiers, which got me like a summoning level and a half. Cool. So now that I had a high enough smithing level to make mithril plate legs, you know, I did a panic on the top of White Wolf Mountain clue. I had a hard clue scroll weight laying around. This is the next step. Finished it up. And that's like nothing to me. Okay. I like not skipping tickets, just because it saves me a little bit of time. Not too much. Cool. I also needed to collect a gold ore so that I can make this Ring of Life, and I took care ter took care of my adamant ore daily while I was doing that, so 17k mining and 3 Addy ore back from 7. Okay. That's funny. Yeah, so I'll put these in here. There. You can see I do have an easy and medium. I just don't feel like doing them. I mean, I could get some ranger boots and make Bodhi upset, that kind of thing, but I'm not really worried about it. Guess I'll go do the Smoke Devil's daily, which is goat horn dust? Yeah, something like that. So, I just spent 136,000 coins and 13,600 tokens. Got a 100% charged chaotic staff. I think that's the first time I've had that. Yep, back to Dungeoneering, at least to hit 90. Then I guess, I don't know, I'll go back to Chaos Dwarves so I can work on this. Yeah, that sounds about right. And finished up a divination level after doing my caches for the day. There's 80, which means I unlocked the next level of Wisps. And here we go. And that's the first skill out of the way for invention as well. And there's the boon. Cool, that's yeah, mage training arena, that's right. So now on to something else. Probably just gonna work on Slayer for a little bit. Oh, wait, yeah, I wanna finish up Dungeoneering, so 350k left to do there. So, working to get all of my Strange Rocks for the week before the weekly reset. Can't remember if I actually done it this week. And 75 construction. I was really close to it, but you know, working on this construction daily, it just finished it up. So there we go. That's what, 3 skills down for Plague's End? Not 4. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6, okay. Well on my way there. Yeah. So, another strange rock to get here, then I'm doing farm runs to get those strange rocks, and I think I have maybe one more. No, that's it. Okay, cool. Then back to just finishing up that dungeoneering for ports. So, a small tip for Ironmen when they're out doing farm runs, they should be on the Lunar Spellbook and use Fertile Soil. That's 3 Astrals and 2 Nature Runes per use. And it acts like Super Compost. So normally Super Compost is pretty difficult to get for Ironmen, unless you're doing like, decently high-level PVM. But Fertile Soil works just the same, and it's really cheap if you're using Earth Staff. So yeah, just doing the occasional farm run, mostly for the herbs, but also for the farming XP. All right, gonna go back to DG pretty soon. I feel like I say that at the end of like every clip I've just made, but I'm only like 264k away. So yeah, I just did a cache, and I need to log out and see what my daily is. And there we go, level 90 dungeoneering. Oh boy. Just gonna post that in clan chat. Yeah, awesome. So, time to go start ports. Oh baby. And with the end of this conversation marks the end of Path of the Glowfree, or the Path of Glowfree. 30,000 strength XP, pretty nice. I didn't even know what the quest rewards were, just kind of knew I needed to get it out of the way. On to the next clip. Just defeated Bork in the Chaos Tunnels for the first time. I got the Femur Bone, which I think I needed for, I think that's one of the polish. Yeah, there we go. Cool. I don't have to come back here ever. I got some, charms and whatnot. That was a quest requirement, which I'm guessing a lot of people can probably figure out what quest it's for. But yeah, on to the next clip. This is a fun bug floating in the sky. It's really strange. It's been happening for a little while. Oh man, where does that tube go? Oh, whoa. There's the end of one of the least rewarding and most annoying quests in the game, Sheep Herder. So, just started Morning Zen Part 1, and I wanted to give people, other Iron Men, that is, a good tip. It's that at the beginning of this quest, just beginning it, you don't have to do anything in it. You can come over here, and this is the dye shop. Yeah, you can buy 10 of each of these dyes. Never know when you really need them. They're used a lot in quests. But especially in this quest, like, Sick of It lists that you need 6 plus for like 4 different types of dye. So I'm just gonna buy out, the shop's inventory, and yeah, whatever I need, I will have, and I don't have to go collect like the woad leaves and the onions and, all of that crap. yeah, so just a little tip there. And here's the end of Morning Zen Part 1, but Part 2, right down here, is not gonna be fun. Oh man. Well, I guess it's that time. I still get a little surprised every time I go to like summon a summoning familiar and I see this pet pop up. I like hear the like creepy sound effect it makes. It's really unexpected. I still can't believe I got that drop on, what was it, like the fourth kill? Oh my gosh. Well, here's the real start of the quest. Oh boy. Wow, I got across the handholds on the second try, and the first try got me to right here. Oh man. The Iron Man luck. I lied, there's no such thing as Iron Man luck. I just failed the handholds for like the fifth time in a row. Oh, oh gosh. I don't wanna have to leave and go get more food. Like, I really don't wanna. I've got the terror bird with food here, so hopefully that'll last me through the last puzzle at least. Needed some white berries. I collected some earlier for super defense potions, but I need to come back for the item list for whatever his name is. Our Morning's End Part 2 for the Death Talisman. And a nice little trick you can do. I thought I'd show it off. You can bring a Beast of Burden up here to help you collect more of them per trip. This is at the Red Dragon Isle in the wilderness. Pick up a burnt bone, drop it, and you get these white berries. They both spawn here. You can just loot them. And see, it has loot custom, which keybinded. You can just press shift space whenever they pop back up. And it's like 750 per hour or something like that, which is pretty nice. And the loot custom is set up in gameplay or loot settings, and basically you just tick it. Let me see, I'll show right here. Go to loot settings, and you just tick loot herbal or items, and that'll be all it picks up with the custom loot. And yeah, it's a pretty good method. It's probably like the only real method of getting white berries for Iron Man, aside from like, I don't know, Corporeal Beast, I think. So yeah, or the white berry bush if you want to do farm runs all the time. Yeah, good little tip there. Well, that actually wasn't too bad. Especially seeing as I had like Dragon's Medallion, so I could skip straight to Barrows to get the book thing that I needed. That would probably have been the hardest part of collecting those items, so. Cool. And there's the end of the big quest. Oh boy. What's this? Don't know if I need this. I gotta run back to the light maze to put back that cyan crystal. Need this to go back to the light maze. Hold on to that. Hold on to that. And, got a new quest to start. All of this has been leading up to one biggin, which is... Whoa, where'd it go? It's not here? What am I missing? Wild Gothic Sleeps. Dream Mentor. Ah, yeah, that's right. And then, I can boost for the farming, or I might just sleep. I planted some maple trees earlier, so then I could come back, do a farm run, and, yeah, I'd be level 65 farming already. That might be what I do. I don't know. We'll see. Oh, that's funny. Another spot where they screwed up, or where Jagex, you know, they missed something. this is during the Plague's End quest, if I remember correctly. So, you know, not only do they show Prif, but they show part of the little side areas during the quest. Oh, man. And there's the end of Dream Mentor. Good XP. What's this lamp for? Huh? It's an XP lamp? Okay. Strength. Probably strength. Yeah, I think strength. Cool. 15,000. Nice. Level up. Alright. On to the next quest. Probably last quest of tonight. But I'm not really sleepy right now, so I might just stay up all night or something like that. Okay. Yeah, I think I'm not gonna bother trying to get the farming boost. I'll just wait until the morning and then run around, do a farm run with my maple trees when they're done, and take care of the quest then. I don't feel like doing, you know, like another 2 hour long quest tonight. but then I'm gonna funnel all of that XP into herb lore, and I'll be 100k away from 75. So it's 1,000 frost dragons to go after that, and, oh yeah, like 1,000 crimson charms or so, or 3,000? Yeah, I think it's like 3,000 crimson charms together. Which, okay, I'll get a lot of ranged levels on water fiends there. Yeah, okay. So, starting off day 60, doing Wild Gothic Sleeps, you can see I'm really far into the quest. And I'm not sure if this is now intended, or if this is just some kind of bug, or if it's because I've unlocked the Ouroboros pouch through, what's it called, temple trekking. But you're supposed to have these druid pouches get used up as you, you know, use them on these druids, and I'm not having any charges lost, so it might have to do with me having the Ouroboros pouch, not sure. I didn't bring it with me or anything. Yeah. nifty little trick there. It really makes the quest easier. You don't have to go around and collect the fungus.
Oh boy, here it comes. 100K herb lore. 100K herb lore. And again. And another one. Okay, there we go. Is that like 74? Yeah, oh boy. 108K away, almost. It's staying on the screen for the cut screen because I'm so excited about getting close to Prif. Oh man. Okay, so after this, I think I'm just going to spend the day PVMing, because I've got that other series I want to make. Today's the like first episode in the series is going to be pretty bland because it's well, let's see, did I unlock anything good? I guess juju potions, but I'm still not up to like super. Oh, super range. There we go. Dwarf weed and wine of Samarak. Cool. I can make a lot of those. What was I saying? Oh yeah, today's going to be a pretty like slow episode to start that series with, because I think I'm just gonna go try to kill 1,000 frost dragons. That's my prayer, 66 to 75. So. Yep.
Well, still working on my day of PVM. Got a crafting daily challenge for red dragonhide vambraces. Definitely skipping that. Whoa, that's interesting. Anyway, yeah, I'm gonna be skipping that one. I got smoke devils again yesterday, which is good since I'm on my way towards Prif, and I need 75, so that'll save me from farming a little bit of Crimson Charms. Something like, I don't know, 40 or 50.
And there's the end of the Knights Waves training ground. So I got these prayers unlocked. Cool. Well, I just finished off my day of PVM, which I spent at Frost Dragons like all day. Came to do a Slayer task so I can finish the rest of the way to 80 attack real quick. And because I want to get to, Abbey Spectres again. First Dust Devil drops a ancient effigy. So that's nice. All right. Just gonna put that 5K on herb lore. And then I have penguin points, which I can claim. That'll get me down to 40,000 remaining. I've got the effigy put me at 35,000. Then I'm gonna go get one of the god banners finally. Use the daily banner boost, and I'll get like 35,000 experience from super magics, and I'll be well over 75 since I have a jack of trades to do today as well. So yeah, 75 herb lore is down. Just got about half of prayer left to go, 70 to 75. Got 63K prayer banked, or about 70K right now, and then summoning, which, I'll probably just slay for most of it. I don't feel like grinding at water fiends nonstop. It feels like a bit of a waste of time unless I'm on slayer tasks. But I want to start going to get tasks from I can't remember a person's name. I think it's Curidel in the the barbarian area near water fiends. Yeah, I'm gonna go get my first task from her pretty soon. There's 77 Slayer, which is a pretty big one. It unlocks Desert Strike Worms. I'm pretty sure I already have Jungle Strike Worms unlocked, and if I don't, they're coming up soon. Which means I'll soon have access to farm both of the different mobs I need for the full Slayer Helm. Oh man, on this kill, there it is, 80 attack. That's a pretty big one. Means I can start training strength for one. Is check that box. It also means that I should grind some dungeoneering again. I don't wanna right now. Oh man. I think I'm at like 70K tokens, right? Yeah, 76K, which means I need like 223, 224. I guess I'd get to like 93 or something, maybe 94, which is pretty cool, but I don't know. Maybe I can start on that tomorrow or something. Or right after I get Prif. Yeah, after Prif sounds good. But you know, if I wait until after Prif, then I'm going to have to deal with like another 400 or 500 frost dragons using this blister wood without, you know, Chaotix. Chaotix would be a lot faster. So I don't know. We'll see what happens. And just got my last strange rock for the week by doing a farm run. Don't know why it took like 4 or 5 farm runs to get this last, to get both strange rocks, that is. It's just kind of unlucky, but at least it's like forcing me to come get some XP. Gonna go turn those in just a moment.
So, first assignment from Curadel. Greater Demons, alright. That'll be some ranged XP. So yeah, I'm at 122 points because I just finished my 75th task, I think. And I need to save for all of these. but aside from that, yeah, I just need enough points to prefer a few different tasks later. Okay. And right after getting the new task, here's me adding to the Statue of Damarok. Please let me explode it. I don't think I have this week. Alright, there we go. And that is piece number 5 or 6? I think it's 6. Yeah. Yeah, it should be 6 because I have one in the bank already. So, there we go. Got that rock. Gotta go add that to my statue and my POH. And yeah. And here I am claiming my penguin points. I forgot that I needed to talk to the bear. I never did that Hunt for Red Racktuber on my other account, so... Yeah, let's see. Experience reward. Herblore? Yeah, 42,500. So, it's pretty good. Okay, Ardoon task, sure. so that leaves me with 41,500 left. Getting pretty close.
Well, I'm doing the God Banner stuff, and I built a very large bonfire in the middle of this dimensional portal. So, that happened. Alright, good game. So, I just hit level 72 thieving with the completion of the emissary, you know, God Banner part 4. Yeah, and got me total level 1950, so I'm really speeding through the 1900s, getting close to that 2k.
So, turning in the Smoke Devil daily, as well as the what I rerolled from the Red Dragonhide Vambrace's daily challenge, it rerolled into Slayer, which, you know, sure. Oh, don't have space for rewards, because she doesn't realize she can just take it out of my inventory. Okay. Let's turn in. 11k summoning. And it's only like 6k Slayer, so that's pretty bad. And a Marigold again. Well. Yep, just working on some summoning. Starting off day 61. And currently rendering a video that I'll be putting up shortly. Hopefully this is better received by those who prefer the shorter series.
So I just finished a Fire Giant task, and I came here. Curadel's offering me the Fire Cape task, and I think I should... Yeah, like, it's not too hard to get a fire cape, especially if I do the resting thing, so I guess I can do that today. That'll be something I take care of. So, yes, I'll accept the challenge. I can do this just because, I don't know, I feel like it might even be a, what's it called? A comp cape requirement to get the, well, I know it is to get the fight kiln capes, but I don't know if it is to do that task at least once, to accept her challenge and do it. But either way, you know, I'll go take care of that. It shouldn't be too difficult. I'll probably take my sharks to use and just abuse the resting thing quite a bit and do it. Yeah, there it is. Yes. Oh no, I'm not gonna risk the DC. Oh my gosh. Oh man. Yeah. So that's probably like 4 hours down here. So not too bad. You know, Alkin's a lucky bastard. I watched his Iron Man series and I saw him get it in like 3 attack levels or something. But there we go. All right. Yeah, today's a good day. Oh man. Okay, add that to the tool belt. Okay. So I thought, you know, I'm gonna wait for familiarization, which is in about like 20 minutes, and I'm like, well, what should I do in the time? I can go fish. Well, I don't have the decorated fishing urns yet. I can go mine, but I've only got a rune pickaxe. Let me go back to the battlefield and try to get that upgrade. Woo! Yeah, today's a good day. So yeah, I'm gonna go mine for like 20 minutes, and then, or maybe I'll just make some urns. Nah, I've got plenty of urns. So yeah, I'm gonna go mine granite for 20 minutes. I'm gonna be using a Sign of the Porter, since I have quite a few of them made, and just be banking all the granite. I think I'll go buy a Tome of Frost, since I don't feel like dealing with the Scrubberas just yet. And, yeah, that just happened. Alright, I think I'm gonna stop the clip now. It's funny, I was just looking it up, like, I was talking in clan chat about grinding away and kept getting heart attacks from, like, Spirit Emerald drop, because it gives me a beam. And then I went to look up, you know, the drop rate to see if it's, oh man, that drop, to see if it's actually 1 in 5,000 for all of the mobs there, or for all of the Chaos Dwarves there. I wanted to see, you know, if Dwogers had a higher drop rate because they're harder to kill, or maybe if the little 1,000 health guys had a lower drop rate, and I just, you know, went back to a Jagex Timbo Twitter comment, or a Twitter a tweet, yeah, tweet, that he was like, you know, D-Pick is 1 in 5,000, it's always been that, it hasn't been changed recently, and as I have that on my second monitor, I get the drop, and I'm like, wait a second, is that a... Oh. Oh, man, that looks so nice. Oh, yeah. Alright, I'm probably not going to have enough porters to do all of, you know, all of the granite I need to 75. Like, there's no way I have that many. But at least getting to 75 now won't take too long. Whoa, what did I take damage for? Water skin. I thought a Tome of Frost stopped me from taking damage. I don't know. I do have one. So maybe I just wasted like 40k? I don't know. So I just completed familiarization for the first time. I don't know what he said. I can give you a reward in return for the... Oh yes, I'd like the reward. Triple charm drops. Yes, please. And I just gotta hold on to that drop enhancer and go get my gear. I thought I was gonna get summoning XP. I don't know if I did. I wasn't paying attention. I don't think I did. I thought I read on here, like, it was a summoning XP as a reward? Yeah. Oh, maybe I'll get it whenever I tear the ticket. Well, I'm going to go to Water Fiends, even though it's sort of a waste of time, because I don't have, what's it called? I don't have a task for them. It's sort of a waste. But that's no big deal. I just need the charms. So hopefully I can get a few hundred. I don't know if that's pushing it or not. But yeah, I'm gonna go do that for a little while. Well, there's the end of the 40 minutes of PVMing that I just did, of 40 minutes of Water Fiends, really, from the Triple Charm drop. You can see 454 Crimson Charms gained, Maybe a little bit more if I can get this one last kill. Please don't die. 3 seconds, 2 seconds, 1 second. No! Oh well. No big deal. Yeah, so this is the total loot. 457 charms, because I take one with me. I don't know how many that is. Let's see, or 456, maybe? Yeah, that's 152 charm drops, so, yeah, it's pretty good XP for the time. I think I started, like, mid-level 71, and I got two-thirds of the way through 73, so, yeah, that's pretty good. Quite a bit XP there. Going to go use up these charms probably fairly soon. And do my daily Nimmy Forest. That's something I need to start doing. Someone reminded me of that. I believe might have been on Reddit or... no, it was in a YouTube comment. Someone reminded me of that. And it's a really good idea to do that one daily. So I'm going to go do that now. And then work on my summoning. And then, you know, daily resets coming up. So I'll do, you know, daily challenge and another Nimmy Forest. It's also going to be weekly reset, so I can do Tears of Guthix again, and yeah, lots of stuff going on. Meg will be available again in 5 minutes. Oh my. So after a long grind, I finished the last of the Varrock medium tasks. That's just because I'm going to be doing Granite, and I needed the higher tier Varrock armor to get that chance for, you know, double ore per mine, which means I had to go catch 100 rats. So yeah, that took a little bit of time, like more than an hour. Okay, on to the next clip. And here is the Varrock Armor 2. Awesome. Never actually accomplished that on my other account, so yeah. Use this antique lamp. I guess I should put on an herb lore. It doesn't really matter that much now. But you know, I still gotta push for like super anti-fires and stuff like that. Okay, now I'm gonna do my Jack of Trades, and then I'm gonna do a court summons. Got 60 gold ore from the court case, that's pretty nice. And 2k herb lore. So, pretty bad Tears of Guthix this week, only 125. But you know, 22,500 summoning XP, not something I can really complain about. Alright, Clockwork Syringe, don't plan on doing that. Yeah. So I've been working on mining quite a bit. I haven't really made any clips for it, but I'm up to 73. I have 162k left until Prif level. Yeah. I burnt through, like, I don't know, 19... decorated mining urns or something like that, just doing granite. And then I started working on empty throne room, just because it's a little more AFK. I've got a really bad crick in my neck, so I wanted to focus on something a little more AFK for the time being. Don't know what I'm going to work on for the rest of the night. Only have, you know, maybe another hour or so of progress left to go. So I might do some fishing for monkfish or something like that. We'll see what happens. It's probably going to be nothing too big. And I just went out, did all the stuff for the day with the girlfriend, and click that button. There we go. 75 mining, 14 levels left. That being 2 ranged, 2 prayer, 10 summoning. 2 ranged are going to come while I collect charms. Going to do familiarization again. That'll definitely get my range out of the way doing Water Fiends. And then Prayer is like, I don't know, a few hundred Frost Dragon Bones. And then Summoning is just, you know, collecting the rest of the charms I need. I think I need somewhere around 2,500 Crimsons. But if I use Blue Charms as well, which I can definitely do, it'll be a lot less. I don't know how many less. I think this is like 200k banked or something like that, which is insane. So yeah, I'm gonna go work on that. So, doing my miscellanea upkeep, coming over here to collect my resources, and that's a decent number of maple logs. I really like the, the herbs. It's not too many herbs, but that's going to my bank. Going to manage, and just because, you know, I'm about to have to burn through a lot of money for summoning, I need as much as I can. So I'm going to disable this for a little bit, and I'm also going to go back to full wood with the rest on herbs. I think rest on mining. Yeah, I think I'm going to leave it there, but I'm not going to get anything out of that for a few days until, you know, I at least unlock Prif. I might only miss a day or two of it, but that's no big deal. But you see, you know, I've got 65 to 75, so I just want to have enough shards so I don't have to go back and forth to Ooglog and keep, you know, trading in shards there. And I want to, you know, hopefully get more from Lord Amlod once that time comes around. So, I've decided I'm going to try for 74. That's what my goal is currently set to. And then after 74, I will do one of a kind, which 74 summoning is the last thing I need. I have all the quests done. And then I'll give me, 80,000 summoning XP, which is most of the way between the two levels. I'll only have like 30k left to do. And as you can see, 74 also unlocks granite lobsters, which, yeah, I've got a lot of granite here. Okay, so time to go blow through these blues and crimsons, and then I'll do familiarization afterwards. No need to grind for blue charm items, because I have soda ash, seaweed, and buckets of sand here, which I can use for molten glass, and the molten glass that I have I can use for fishbowls, which are for the, can't remember what they're called, like something overlords? They're like a level 6, yeah, Karamthulu overlords, which give, I don't know, like 500 XP each, and if I can blow through 200 of those, that's, you know, that's quite a bit, so. And there we go, got the Shard of Zeros. 50k summoning, 100k divination, 125k magic, like that's some great XP there. I can now do Muzzpas and Nihils if I want to. New boons, portents, and signs. Oh, maybe that's why I couldn't make the higher portents. I don't know. Okay, Slayer level, magic level. Awesome, enchant onyx. Alright. Fury Amulet, I hear ya. 78, Lord of Vampirium. And, yeah, now 370k away from the summoning. Alright. I really gotta say, that combat was really hard. Like, I have a Chaotic Staff, you know, Garb of Subjugation, Hood of Subjugation, then Lunar Pieces here, and the God Cape. It was really hard to kill those Nihils, like, even with tier 80. I didn't do the little comp cape requirement that apparently exists to fight all four at the same time. I might do that later. Maybe I'll get tier 90 or something first. I don't know. we'll see what happens there. So, I just did my second cache of the day, right after finishing that quest. So, the quest was 100k divination. Cache was 47.7, and then I've done 3 out of 4 of the measure things. This is going to be going to the final one. So that's a total of 347,700 divination experience within like 20 minutes. I mean, that's breaking a million an hour effectively. I'm getting them gains. So I just gotta run like down there, down south. It's like this area. Alright. After that, I got that summoning, and then the last 100k prayer. Oh man. So, blown through all of my summoning ingredients. I'm here picking up some XP lamps that I have from the World Wakes, putting them on Herb Lore. So that's 100k. 200k. Oh, I've already chosen Herb Lore, so I have to pick something else. I have no idea. I guess 100k runecrafting, because that's I mean, that's decently slow. And 100k on something else? Construction, maybe? These are kind of a waste. Construction. Oh, mining. Yeah, 100k mining. That's good. Alright. There we go. My summoning is up to here. 228k left. Going to go do familiarization, like right now. I gotta go get the infinite run energy here. I didn't do that the first time I did familiarization, and I realize why it's important. Now, so gonna go do that. I should update this little overlay to say 1978. That's 20 total level, come on. And then, gonna go kill water fiends for an hour. I'll probably wait for that until the morning, just so I can get some rest right now. Not really sleepy, I just kind of want to go to sleep. Yeah, and then tomorrow is probably gonna be Prif. I mean, 100k prayer. I'm considering doing fruit bats and burning through like 1,000 of my what's it called? 1,000 green charms. I think it's this one. If it's not this one, I'm gonna be kind of sad. Yeah, salty. Okay, that seems right. All right, and time to go to pick up sticks. So apparently familiarization is on its like own schedule or something. I don't know. It says come back in 5 days, and the weekly reset. I mean, the weekly reset was 2 days ago, but I did it like right before, like the hour before the reset. So I don't know. I guess I'll have to go farm my own charms or something like that. But if I do end up burning through my 1,000 greens, that'll get me about 120,000 XP off of fruit bats, and then 100,000 left to go, which means like 400 crimsons, maybe. Maybe a little bit more than that, but I do need to get ranged the rest of the way to 75, so these will definitely come along with it. And yeah, I have to wait for this shop to restock. Might have to go farm some cows, like I said. Yeah, and farm bananas. I don't know how I'm gonna do that. I'll probably just do the fruit bat and cast the spell over and over again, and eventually I'll get them. So yeah, that's the plan. It's gonna be a bit of a grindy day tomorrow, but I'll definitely be get 75 out of the way. Okay, I kind of expected to get more bananas from doing the fruit fall scroll thing, but it's pretty terrible. I think I've blown through maybe like 50 scrolls, and I'm like break even on bananas, so it really just feels like a waste of time. I could just be grinding out crimsons with water fiends and getting like raw beef. I mean, chain and dragon breath really take down those cows, you know? Yeah, I'm just not gonna try this anymore. I'm just gonna go for the crimsons. Starting day 63, got one of my dailies out of the way. It's an iron ceremonial sword one, so it blew through a lot of my iron ore. Let's see, it's about 16,500 extra smithing, which is pretty good, and 19 rune. That's nice. But I already hit 71. Now I'm halfway through. To 72, which that has me well on my way towards the 80 I need. Yeah. So I have an idea, and that's to go do the Yak Twi stick. Do I have one of those? No, I don't. But go get an enhanced Yak Twi stick and use those charm slices to help towards summoning. I don't know how much I'll actually get from that. But I may as well go see, because that's something I need for Hunter in the first place. It'll give me some Hunter XP. And it's a comp requirement, so I'll have to do it eventually, regardless. So yeah, I'm gonna go work on that. If it's not that great in terms of charms, then I don't know what I'll go do. Probably just farm charms elsewhere, like water fiends. Over here, grinding out some water fiends, because I needed to for, 75 ranged after all, and that's coming up right here on this kill. I did charm sprites for a little bit. I got like, I don't know, 25 crims or something, and yeah, that takes a little bit too long for me. So there's the 75 ranged out of the way. I wasn't really counting it in like a requirement for Prif because it's so easy to get, really. But yeah, that's out of the way now. So there's the 100k prayer left, and then the rest of summoning. So I'm just going to keep grinding here. I know I don't really need to, but I might stay here all the way to 80, honestly. I could always use 80 range so I can get to chaotic crossbows, or maybe like a tuned crystal before then. Probably not. And then use up my summoning supplies, probably farm a little bit of raw beef, and then like 150 frost dragon bones, and whatever that last quest is, within the light, or the light within. I think it's within the light, because the light within is the one you start in Prith after Prith. Yeah, within the light. Okay. That one. Yeah, I gotta go do that one. I didn't expect the clue to finish right there. Oh man, another court summons. Oh, I want to re-roll it so bad. Because, I mean, it's a Ceridoman body, it's kind of meh. But the court summons, alright, I'll keep it. It's a hard clue skull reward. I got one earlier and I forgot to do it, and then I did all that farming at Water Fiends, and I didn't get another drop, and I'm like, huh, that's kind of weird. Why didn't I get another drop yet? And it's because I already had a clue scroll. So there's the second court case I've done complete. The first one was the mugger one. I'm not sure if I took a clip for that. Cool, raw monkfish. That's like perfect. all right. And combat XP lamp. Oh, can I? Oh. Oh. Happily. I didn't expect that. I expected it to be like a normal, you know, the other combat skills XP lamp, not a... that's pretty nice. I think these feathers are pretty useless, so I'm just gonna drop those. And then I've got a Ceridoman body, which might help if I decide to go to Sarah. But I just did that quest. What is it? Fate of the Gods? So I've got an ancient... the Shard of Zeros, that is... So I don't have to worry about, you know, getting aggroed by anything. Ever. Yeah. Oh well, at least I've got, you know, some fun stuff in the clue tab building up. I think I took a video for that too, Runehelm H2, so I've got like 3 unique items, I guess. So instead of, like, mindlessly killing cows and... I decided to go for the Arty Cloak, and I got Arty Cloak 2. And I'm only a few away from Articloak 3. It'll speed up farm runs, for one. I think it's better than the Warpriest Cloak. Let's see, where's it at? Right here. So 33 armor versus 11, but you get 9 to all as well as 3 prayer. Like, this is definitely better than the Warpriest Cape. So it'll be an upgrade for melee, at least. And for ranged, I'd say. The Attractor is kind of... crap, because it's only 2 armor difference versus 3 prayer. So yeah, this is good. Speeds up farm runs. I put the XP lamps onto summoning, which is like 8,500 or something. No big deal. So yeah, I'm gonna go buy the raw beef again in Canifus and Ooglog, and just slowly letting it build up. Just got this one level to power through, and then I'm pretty much there. Alright, so I went and did some Frost Dragon farming, coming in with level 75 prayer. Probably gonna have to go back to them eventually. No, I can do the Sun Spear Firewatch thing for the rest of my prayer levels, probably, between that and, what's it called? Cleansing Saren Stones at Prif. There's 75 prayer. And 75 summoning still. I'm about to use Jack of Trades on it in just over an hour. And I'm considering going and doing my Reaper task right now, whatever I have currently. It might be Krill or something like that. Just because I'll probably get some charm drops from the boss. So yeah, 14 Krill kills. I'll go do that just for something a little different. And because I plan on doing a lot of Slayer this weekend on the Slayer embossing weekend. And I figure I may as well get some more Reaper points while I'm at it. So I've done 4 kills here now. And I think I could sustain for just about forever. I want to leave before the hour flips, you know, so I could get another Reaper task, and because I want to send my ships out again. They both just finished missions. But I'm not going to worry about it, you know? I'm just going to stay here as long as I can and see what my KC ends up being, because I can still use more pieces from here. And there's the first drop at the end of the sixth kill. Got a Godsword Shard 1. I don't have one of those yet. Only have a Godsword Shard 3 in the bank. Yeah. So one more piece and a hilt, and I'll have my first Godsword. Hopefully that'll end up being a Sarah hilt, but I don't know when I plan on going to the Sarah boss, so.
Well, I got another subjugation piece. It's sadness. Sadness is what that piece is. It's good to have at least one of them in case, you know, I gotta do some resonance stuff at bossing, but... Okay. I'll take it. Whatever.
If I remember right, this was the last possible Slayer assignment I could get. Maybe that was the one before it, but I got 12,000 Slayer XP, 12 Reaper points, which is, it's pretty good. You know, 12 points. I don't know what I'm up to now. Let's see. Get Bond. No. 92 points. I will go just before the hour ends and pick up another assignment for today before the reset, and then I'll do that tomorrow after noon. After noon ticks, you know, and it's going to be 50% bonus Slayer XP. I don't know if it applies to me or not, but if it does, I want to take advantage. Yeah, and then after that, I'll do that Slayer assignment. I'll wait till after the reset. I'll pick up another one. You know, go from there. Well, there's 80 defense, and that's, you know, something. And then I got an effigy. Okay, Wine of Zamorak drop. It's worth a lot on the GE, so it pops up with a beam every time. Kind of saddened by this effigy because that's number 4 or 5 here, but I can't get any, like, decent equipment drops. It's it's painful, man. What's this KC up to now? Let's see. Krill. 205. In 205, I have gotten a, like, 1 in 50 chest, 2 1 in 50s helm. The 1 in 50 here, so that's about average, okay, but I missed the 1 in 72 spear, like, 3 times over now, and I've gotten 2 Godsword shards, which are, I think they're supposed to be a lot less rare than 200 KC for all 3 of them. I don't know. It just feels really unlucky, aside from the effigies. I guess 5k summoning, sure, that's gonna finish off this level, and then I'll have, you know, another to take care of. 80 defense is pretty good, though. So I think only a few more kills, and then I'll be heading out of here. So, got my new daily. It's a Slayer daily. Oh, my new, my Reaper task for yesterday, right before the reset, is a what's it, Barrows. So there's that. I'll definitely take care of that later tonight. Like after the weekend starts. Here's turning in Jack of Trades. No, not this guy, this guy. Yeah, here's turning in Jack of Trades for summoning right now, just because, yeah, it's kind of rough. I'm getting closer. I'm getting much closer. 95k to 74, then a quest, and then like 20k left to grind, and I'm done. So maybe. I still have a good chance at getting Prif tonight. I mean, yeah. I've got like 200 Crimsons right here I can blow through, so time to go do that. Here's me turning in a daily challenge for Barbarian Leaping Sturgeons, just because I don't want to lose a daily if I don't do one by tomorrow. A single Rocktail. yeah, that's what my current dailies are, and this would, they would all take a while. I mean, Pyramid Plunder, the agility will be the next thing I do if I don't get something good tomorrow. The teaks, I don't think I have enough logs for that right now. And then Admiral Pies, I'm just gonna spend like one of my miscellanea days collecting some tuna for this, and then collect the salmon
myself, but that's just gonna stay there for a while. Yeah.
Heart beating so hard. There's Jad done, though. No longer have to worry about that. Ugh. All right. And there is this monthly out of the way. Gamer summoning 42,000. That's a little more than I expected from it, honestly. So 17,000 left to go through. And, yeah, I'm there. No, not quite. And with that, I finished one of a kind. It just... Okay. It completely took away my box there. Let's see. Divination Lamp. 5k. Alright. Dungeoneering. 45k. Summoning. 80k. Magic Lamp. 90k. Cool. I don't think I need this. Or this. Or this. And Dragon Rider Amulet. Oh, man. 30 to all types, plus a 10 prayer bonus. I can even destroy my Lunar Amulet. Because that was only 30 magic bonus without the 10 prayer. And that means I can put my recently made Amulet of Power just in the Clue Scroll tab. And this Amulet of Strength. Bye-bye. Drop that in there. Right here. And anti-fire pot. Okay. And with the end of that quest, I did get an extra, like, 10,000 summoning XP bonus, which was nice. So I have 24k left to go through. Each granite lobster is worth 300 and something. Got 200 crimson charms. I only need like 80. Let's do this. I don't think I'm gonna run through the raw beef. It's just a big waste right now. Okay. And here it is, the last button press. Oh no, did I miscalculate? I totally did. 42. 42 experience, man. Alright, that's kind of awkward. Well, with this level, I will have all of the requirements I need for Prif out of the way, except for the one quest. I'm going to do that quest and Prif back to back, but I don't think that is going to make it into this episode. I know, I'm keeping everyone waiting a week to see the big, juicy quest complete. But, you know, that's not too bad, right? I'm doing all the work here. So, single granite lobster. Come on now. There we go. That was the last button press for Prif. There we go. Okay. All the levels you need to complete Plague's End. Alrighty. Well, okay, time to go, like, shower, and then I might sleep, or I might go ahead and do, what's it called? Within the Light? No, that's not it. Yeah, it is. Within the Light. But it's just gonna be Within the Light, and then Plague's End, back to back. Yeah. It's been a good week, guys. Thanks for watching.